Rajasthan. The land offers a colorful blend of music, massive forts, diverse cultures, exquisite cuisines, and warm people, set in a rugged yet inviting landscape. People take pride in their 5,000 years old diverse culture and tradition, which is their guiding light till date. The culture is so diverse that it is believed that the dialect, cuisine, water, and turban in Rajasthan changes every 12 miles. Rajasthan is the largest state in India with a total population of 68.6 million, where women constitute 32.6 million, which is less than 50% of the total population. Deeply ingrained social practices, traditions, and customs passed down through generations have created a culture that accepts discrimination against women as a part of life. This discrimination shows up in some of the most troubling statistics on the status of women in Rajasthan.
ને પાઈ પાઈ પણ્યા પછી 18 સાલ થઈ ગયા શાદી કરાવી દીધી બાલ બચ્ચ થઈ ગયા તે પણવાને મેં કઈ વહે યાદ રેજ્યું નહીં એવો પણવાના આજ્યું એ તે અગોટા કરતો તો તે
એઝ પર ધ 2011 સેન્સસ વુમન રિસીવ વેરી લિટલ સ્કૂલિંગ દસ ઓન્લી 52% ઓફ વુમન ઇન રાજસ્થાન આર લિટરેટ એઝ કમ્પેર્ડ ટુ 79% ઓફ મેન. UNICEF identified the need of literacy amongst women not only to empower them but also to play a vital role in nurturing her children. Thus, UNICEF and Development Alternatives joined hands to address this problem in Rajasthan through the TARA Akshar Literacy Program.
UNICEF Rajasthan has been working with the children in tribal districts. And while we did our work, we find that the mothers of these children who are in school are not participating in their children's education in any way. And one of the reasons was because they were illiterate. They didn't have the confidence to go to a school management committee and say something because they could not even sign. They were doing thumb impressions. So we started talking to DA and we got their inputs, which where they have worked in Uttar Pradesh and the kind of work they have done there with women's literacy. So we decided to take this up as a pilot.
TARA Akshar has evolved through stages of intensive grassroots level research and study of best practices globally. The inclusive model of TARA Akshar program is not only confined to women but also promotes community development as a whole. The districts of Udaipur and Dungarpur were chosen to implement the TARA Akshar program. Four civil society organizations who were already functional in the concerned districts were chosen. With the help of our partners, we identified 57 villages across the two districts and started mobilizing the community.
Community mobilization ko rigorous level pe ek intensive level par karne ka zarurat tha. Hum logon ne 15 days ka batch form karne se pehle PRI members ke saath mein जो कम्युनिटी लीडर्स हैं, जो पूर्व सरपंच रहे हैं या जो वर्तमान में भी वहाँ के पीआरआई लीडर्स हैं और जो समुदाय के दूसरे बड़े लोग थे, उनके साथ हम लोगों ने मीटिंग ऑर्गेनाइज किए. उन्हीं परिणामों के फलस्वरूप इतने सेंटर्स हम लोग चला पाए और एसएचजीज के अलावा जो महिलाएं दूसरी भी थी वो भी महिलाओं को देख के भी मोटिवेट हुई कि जब ये महिलाएँ पढ़ लिख कर इतना अच्छा आगे कर रही हैं तो क्यों ना हम भी जुड़े.
Local instructors and supervisors were selected and they went through a rigorous in-house training for 17 days. The program starts with 56 days of software-based TARA Akshar and TARA Ganit, which imparts functional literacy in Hindi and basic mathematics. A batch of 30 illiterate women are enrolled in the TARA Akshar classes.
ઘરવાળાએ પૂછ્યું પણ અમારા સહેલી જઈ એના હાથે પણ પણવા જમ એમ તે જો એમ તે આમાં ગઈ પણવા તે પણ ની અમે સમજમાં બી બેઠું પણ બાર થોડું ઘણું આવી બી ગયું હે પણ ની બી ખરી સબ સમજમાં બેઠું અમે આ તારા અક્ષર પણ ની.
TARA Akshar uses a highly intelligent software which objectifies things of daily use from the lives of learners and associates it to letters and numbers. We call it the revolutionary memory hook technique, which is embedded in animated movies to teach letters, syllable, and numbers. This idea is reinforced by a series of exercises conducted daily to strengthen reading and writing skills of learners.
अपने दोनों अंगुलियों को कंधे के साथ से ठीक है, कंधे की सहायता से क्या बनाना है, जैसे ये।
After 56 days, learners graduate to Gyan Chaupali, which is an interactive platform aiming to impart comprehensive information and strengthen the literacy base of women. Gyan Chaupali uses various forms of edutainment to strengthen application of literacy in the lives of our learners. Thus, information on health and sanitation, women's rights, child rights, agriculture, and government schemes are provided via tablets or guest speaker sessions.
दस्ताना क्यों पहनते हैं पता है आपको? आप लोगों? दस्ताना पहनते हैं इसलिए कि वो जो दवाई होती है ना बहुत तेज होती है। दवाई अगर दस्ताना नहीं पहनेंगे तो दवाई जो है हमारे शरीर पर दवाई का नुकसान भी हो सकता है।
Women see Gyan Chaupali as a platform to come together to not only study but to meet her friends and neighbors. Or just to have a chat. This program has empowered women to take up their roles in their family and community in a more informed way.
मेरे घरवाले का नाम लक्ष्मी है, तो मैं बाहर शहर के काम के लिए जाता था, तो वो मेरे को चिंता थी कि मतलब वो अनपढ़ है, पीछे काम कैसे संभालेगी। मेरे गांव में एक तारा अक्षर का कार्यक्रम आया, फिर हमने उनको पढ़ने के लिए कहा, तो वो पढ़े वहाँ। फिर वो समझ सके, अब मैं बाहर जाता हूँ तो वो हिसाब रख सके, वो हमें तक दिक्कत नहीं होती।
She has started participating in various decision-making processes in the family, managing finances in a more sound manner. Women have become more sensitive towards the importance of education for their children. They regularly monitor homework, attend school management committee meetings and keep a track of children's attendance in school. Women are seen to be more independent as now they go and buy goods of daily use by themselves and are confident enough to count money and make transactions easily. There is an urge to bring a change in her own life and do something more than what she has been doing all her life. She keeps herself better informed and tries to read headlines from the newspaper and sometimes discuss it with her family and neighbors. She no longer has to approach others to help her make a phone call. Rather, we see young women in villages who own mobile themselves and use it for their day-to-day purposes.
Tara aksar banaya ji 8 mahina banni te sign bhi karan em naam vasa vision bhi vasa lucky vidyan vasa bhi kare એમ થોડોક સબ હિસાબ કિતાબ રહે ને દુકાનમાં સામાન લેવા જા તે બી હિસાબ કિતાબ સબ કરા સામાન લાવા અતરા પૈસા થા જા અતરા ને થા જા એમ સબ કરા સોર બી સ્કૂલ જે સ્કૂલમાં મીટિંગ થાય મીટિંગમાં બી જા સોર હાથે તું બી ભણ એમ કે તે થોડી થોડી વાળા સોર હાથે હું બી ભણું ને સોરે બી ભાળો સબ એમ લખો કામ હું આલ્યું આજ મેડમે ને આજ વાળું કામ કીધું યા નહીં કીધું યા એમ સબ હિસાબ કિતાબ સબ જુઓ.
વુમેન ફીલ અ સેન્સ ઓફ પ્રાઇડ ધેટ ધે નો લોંગર આર ઇલિટરેટ એન્ડ કેન સાઇન ઇન બેંક્સ ઓર ઇન અધર ગવર્મેન્ટ ઓફિસિસ. ધ સ્ટિગ્મા ઓફ બીંગ રેફર્ડ ટુ એઝ અનપઢ ઓર ઇલિટરેટ હેઝ બીન વાઇપ્ડ ઓફ ફ્રોમ ધેર લાઇવ્સ ફોર એવર. વુમેન ટેક પ્રાઇડ ઇન બીંગ ફંક્શનલી લિટરેટ એન્ડ ધીસ ગિવ્સ અસ અ સેન્સ ઓફ અચીવમેન્ટ.
The long-term objective of this program is to understand how this literacy initiative has brought changes in lives of women. Is there any qualitative impact it is having in their lives? How it is getting reflected in their day-to-day happenings of life? And what can be the way to document the processes, the learnings, so that the program can be taken forward in a sustainable manner for years to come?
Tara Akshar is walking an extra mile to go beyond mere literacy. We are very happy that we got an opportunity to work with UNICEF Rajasthan. In this process, we not only explored new geographies but have also strengthened our program. Tara Akshar is giving wings to women to fly, and with these wings of empowerment, they are soaring high.